it's me, Digit Galore. Listen, I'm on my way to the Kids Grinch Virtual Rainbow Ranch for a fun day of activities. We're going to read some stories, we're going to do some crafts, play some drums, and have a whole bunch of fun. Oh, boys and girls, why don't you join us today? We're on our way now. Let's go. For today's first story, I'm going to read one of my favorite books. It's called Remarkably You, and it's written by my good friend Pat Miller. Let's dive right in. You might be bold. You might be loud. Leading parades and drawing a crowd. Look, they're having a parade. You might be timid. You might be shy. Quietly watching your neighbors go by. See the little boy with his balloon? He's watching the end of the parade. You might be small, one tiny sprout, learning new things when you're out and about. You might be big, practically grown, coming and going with friends of your own. Look at the baseball team. I bet they're going right to the game now. No matter your volume, your age, or your size, you have the power to be a surprise. You have the know-how. You're savvy and smart. You could change the world. Are you willing to start? Look at the little boys up here on the edge with his telescope, looking out over the big new world. Don't sit on the sidelines. Be part of the fray. Go after your passions a little each day. Find what needs fixing. Repair what you can. Then choose a new problem and do it again. Look, they're fixing the wheel on the wagon. Wonder what happened. Perhaps you're uncertain, not sure what to do. Just look for the moments that let you be you. Like maybe you're funny or bookish or fast. Or maybe you're always decidedly last. Look at this little rollerblading girl. This little dog has such short legs. That's maybe why they're not going so fast. Perhaps you like counting or drawing all day. Or finding invisible dragons to slay. You have your own spirit, unparalleled flair. So rock what you've got every day, everywhere. Perhaps you wander, or wonder, or sing. The world needs your voice and the gifts that you bring. Look at this one. He's singing to all of these grandpas and grandpas. Grandmas and grandpas. You can make a difference in big ways or small. You don't know how much till you give it your all. So find what you're good at. What you have to give, then go share your sunshine wherever you live. You might be a helper who's first on the scene. Oh, look, she dropped her ice cream and this little girl is coming with another scoop to help her out. You might be a speller, a builder, or a jump roping queen. A swimmer who knits, a cellist who cheers, a much-loving cat cuddler who volunteers. Look at Furry Friends Pet Shelter. He's walking all of these dogs and this little cat's up here in his hood. You are a blessing, a promise, a prize. You're capable, caring, courageous, and wise. You might go unnoticed or shine like a star, but wherever you go and whoever you are, don't change how you act just to be like the rest. Believe in yourself and the things you do best. Look, she's hanging upside down. So whether you're daring or careful or kind, embrace who you are and the way you're designed. Dream your own dreams. Hear your own heart. You can change the world. You just have to start. Follow your path. Do what you love to do. Be completely, uniquely, remarkably you. Isn't that a wonderful story? So whatever you want to do, you can go out, you can be an artist, you can sing, you can help recycle, pick up a piece of trash off the ground. Whatever you do, make sure you do it the best you can. Mwah! Love you. Your own copy today or whenever you can. It's okay to be different is the title of this book, and I like it because it well, you'll see. It's okay to be different. It's okay to be missing a tooth or two or three. Look, he's missing so many teeth. It's okay to need some help. See, this person is sight impaired and she has a seeing eye dog. It's okay to have a different nose. This elephant's long nose. It's okay to be a different color. Now, I have seen a black and white zebra, but I have never seen a rainbow zebra. So if you find one, you give me a call. It's okay to have no hair. Look, no hair and a big hair bow. My dad has no hair. It's okay to have big ears. It's okay to have wheels. Look, this guy's in a little wheelchair going super fast. It's okay to be small, medium, large, or extra large. I would say I'm a large, I hope. It's okay to wear glasses. Look at those big glasses. Oh, I bet she can see real good. It's okay to talk about your feelings. Look, you can purr or grrr or roar. It's okay to eat macaroni and cheese in the bathtub. Oh, we have to talk. I don't think you should eat macaroni and cheese in the bathtub, but maybe you could have toys. You could have rubber duckies or boats, or you could make bubbles. But let's keep the macaroni and cheese at the dinner table. A little less messy. It's okay to say no to bad things. Uh-oh, there's a hook in the water, and these fish want to bite it, but they're going to say no. It's okay to come from a different place. Look at this little alien man. He must have come from Saturn here, and he says, grr, geek. That must mean hello, friend. It's okay to be embarrassed. Uh-oh, this lady has toilet paper stuck to her shoe. She must have just come from the bathroom. Somebody should tell her that. I'd be more embarrassed that her shoes are two different colors, though, honestly. Oh, she looks like my mom. It's okay to come in last. Oh, I have come in last a lot of times. I'm not the fastest runner, but I can read really fast. Finish. See, the turtle is crossing the finish line, but he's finishing. That is important. It's okay to dance by yourself. I dance by myself all the time. That's how I like to start every day. Puts me on the right foot. It's okay to have a pet worm. Look, his name must be Worm because he's in his own house right here. It's okay to be proud of yourself. Look, this lady is proud. She's got a big hairdo, just kind of like mine. Maybe he modeled that after me. It's okay to have different moms. Look, there's a different mom. There's a different mom. It's okay to have different dads. There's a different dad, and there's a different dad. It's okay to be adopted. Now look at this. There is a kangaroo, and he has adopted this little puppy with one blue eye. And look how happy they are. They must be going to a birthday party. It's okay to have an invisible friend. Do you have an invisible friend? Oh, I hope you do. They're a lot of fun. It's okay to do something nice for someone. Now, this kitty cat is giving this mouse a piece of pizza. And it looks like it's the last piece of pizza. That's very nice. It's okay to lose your mittens. The snowman looks surprised. His mittens are in the snow. I hope he can get to them. Looks cold. It's okay to get mad. Oh my goodness, when I first saw this page, I thought it was going to say, it's okay to stink. Because this skunk looks like he's stinky, but I think he just got mad. But it's okay to get mad as long as you can calm back down. It's okay to do something nice for yourself. This boy has bought 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 scoops of ice cream for himself. I hope he shares that with friends. That would give him a tummy ache. I don't think 10 scoops is nice for one person. It's okay to help a squirrel collect nuts. This little girl has her purse full of nuts. And this little squirrel has a purse full of nuts. I hope they share. That would be nice. It's okay to have different kinds of friends. Look, this lady is friends with this doggy, and this man is friends with this boy. Oh, it's okay to make a wish. The dog is wishing for a big bone. Oh, I hope he gets it. Oh, maybe for Christmas or the holidays, Hanukkah. It's okay to be different. You are special and important just because of being who you are. And Todd signed it, Love, Todd. I think that's his doggy with sunglasses right there. Isn't it a wonderful story? It's okay to be different, and that's what makes this world amazing, that we can all come together, we can all read stories and make new friends. So I'll see you for the next story. Bye.
Hey everybody, today for our craft activity, we are going to make razzle dazzle recycle rainbows. Here's mine. Why I call them recycled is because you can find the stuff you need to make this anywhere in your house. All you have to do is go foraging in your own home. So, first thing is the rainbow needs a base. I use cardstock, which is like a strong paper. It makes kind of a sound when you wave it. But you can use anything you find in your house. Like this was a cereal box. I even cut it up. I took the cereal out. There was still cereal. You could use a piece of a cereal box. You could use a pizza box. You could use an Amazon box. They come to your house all the time, a Target box. Anything that's a little sturdy, and all you have to do is cut it into a rectangle or a square, or you could have your parents help you do that. Or, it's another piece of the blue cardstock, I have some pink, or you could use plain old computer paper, which we all have. You just have to swipe a piece from your parents' printer. So let's get started. I think I'm gonna use the blue cardstock. So what do you need? Let's see. To make our rainbow, you need a pen or a marker or a crayon you could write with a pencil, all right, any of those things. And we're going to make a guide for our rainbow. And what we need to do is we're going to make curves or arches, or you could call it the letter C. And we're going to make 7 of them. So I'm going to make it, and then I'm going to hold it up and show you. So the first one you're going to make really small. And this one looks like a half circle. And then what you're going to do is you're going to trace your next one around that, and then the next one around that. So it gets a little bit bigger. Let me show you. So, and we're going to make 7 half circles. So that was 1. This one is 2, 3. I'll show you halfway. I'm going to keep going. 4, 5, 6, and 7. So now I have my guide for my rainbow. And the next step to make it like the one, like my finished product, all of these little pieces, this is all torn or cut paper, and it's all scraps. So what could our scraps be made of? Let's see, I'm gonna put this down. Our scraps could be construction paper. So this, that's construction paper that I actually ripped it up. I didn't even cut it. This is a random piece of sparkly paper that I found in my house, or maybe you could use wrapping paper. So you could cut that up and use it as a scrap. This is a page from a magazine. You could use magazine. You could use newspaper. Just look, when you look in the magazine, look for parts that are very colorful. So this had a lot of blue in it, and I thought that was pretty cool. Or plain old construction paper. Or, I just thought of this, if you don't have any of that, you could take white computer paper and you could color the colors with a crayon or a marker and then rip them up. So you need paper scraps. And you need a glue stick, or if you don't have a glue stick, you could use white glue, or you could use tape, or you could use glitter glue. Anything that's sticky, whatever sticky stuff you like. So I'm choosing to use the glue stick. I think it works nicely on this paper. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start, and I'm gonna put glue on the top of my rainbow, and I'm gonna start out here with red. So we're gonna go red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, okay? So I'm gonna put some glue down. Whoops, my glue stick on. Put some glue down. And I'm gonna find my red paper. So I prepared a little bit and I tore this up, but you could tear it up as you go. And I'm gonna tear it up a little more. And I like to tear it because I like the jaggedy edges. I think they look cool. But if you want it to be a certain size or shape, you can always cut it. Okay, whatever your choice is. And I am sticking the pieces down in my glue along the pieces of my rainbow. So I'll hold it up and show you where I got started. So I started with the red and I put my pieces here, and I'm just gonna fill that whole thing in. Okay, and so you would just keep going. I'm going to skip a little bit. I'm going to skip ahead, and I'm going to go into the next color, and maybe I'll return back to that later and work on it later. So now I've got to put my glue down again, and I'm going to stick some of these orange pieces down. So rainbow is red, orange. Yeah, that's right, red, orange. And if you have the white glue, the kind that, you know, it's in a big container, it's more liquid, you might want to put a dot, just a dot of that glue on your piece and then stick it down, okay? But if you have the glue stick, I think it's easier to just put that glue right on your paper and then smash it down. So these are kind of perfect squares. I'm going to rip them up. Remember I told you I like them ripped up. Whoops, that guy doesn't want to stick. If that happens to you, you just go back and stick it again. All right. And and now I'm gonna go to yellow. And one of the things I wanna show you with yellow, I will lift this guy up, is So there's my red and my orange. I just put the glue for yellow. Sometimes you might have a piece of paper that doesn't fit into your rainbow spot, right? You can always cut it so that it fits into your space. Or you can rip it and try to do the same thing. Whatever makes you happy, whatever you like. And something that's cool about this project is if you don't have time to finish it right now, you can just do what you can now and you can come back to it. You can set it aside and you can work on it later. So as you see, I've added some yellow. So if you remember, we called it a razzle dazzle recycled rainbow. And so that recycled is I'm using things that I found in my home, but what gives it razzle dazzle to me, that is, here's the one I finished. I threw in some sparkly paper I found. Here's some sequins, all right? And I have a bin of sequins, all right? And whatever, I'm lucky to have these sequins. You might have some sequins, you might have buttons, you might have some yarn, you might have feathers. I didn't think about that. Feathers would be really cool. Any kind of things you have that could give texture to your rainbow or razzle dazzle, jazz hands, razzle dazzle, that would brighten it up. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look in my magical basket of sequins and try to find some pieces that match my rainbow. Like I just found a little red one. And I'm gonna add that, you wanna add that to the section of your rainbow that it matches. So I'm putting the red sequin in my red rainbow area, the red stripe of the rainbow. And let me see what else I can find. Oh, here's a green flower. I didn't even do the green paper yet, but I'm gonna put this green right there. That's where I would be putting my green paper, all right? I'll actually put a few pieces around there so you can see what that looks like. And so here goes the greens. Oops. Next to my razzle dazzle green. Let's see, what else do I got? I have a yellow, big yellow thing. So I'm gonna put that in. There, for a little sparkle. So to finish this, you would just continue. Finish your red all the way to the bottom. Finish your orange, your yellow, your green, your blue, and your purple. And then add some razzle dazzle, whatever you can find that you can glue on. And then if you want to define your rainbow a little bit, I'm gonna show you. So here's the one that I showed you in the beginning, the one that was finished. I'm gonna take my scissors and I'm gonna cut it out. So I'm gonna just trace right along the edge of the rainbow. Cut it out, it's kinda cool. And if you don't want to cut it out, that's okay too. But I think this will make it look a little bit cooler. And let's see. In the bottom of my rainbow, you know, there's that little opening that we didn't color in with paper. I'm going to cut that out too. Just take your scissors around. And if this is a little tricky for you, you can ask someone to help you, a grown-up to help you. And then there is my razzle dazzle recycled rainbow. And some other things that you could do with this, well, first thing, you could give it to a friend that you love and say, happy pride. You could tape it in your window to show that you are celebrating pride. You could hang it on the wall in your bedroom or on the refrigerator where a lot of great art goes. Or you could have a grown-up help you and you could punch a hole right here and tie a ribbon. And then you could hang it. You could hang it off a doorknob. You could hang it in your bedroom. You could hang it anywhere you want. Razzle dazzle rainbow. I hope you have fun making it. And I hope you have a razzly dazzly rainbow pride. Bye.
It's time for another story. Now, this is another one of my favorite books. It's called Neither. And it's written by my good friend, Arlie Anderson, and it is a story about acceptance. So excited. Once upon a time, there were two kinds, this and that. these, and those. One or the other. Until, what's happening? See this little egg? What's going on? Honk! What kind are you? I'm both. You can't be both. You must be neither. I'm neither. Oh, he's so stale. Neither tried to play a this game. You can't play with us. You're not rabbity enough. Neither tried to play a that game. You can't play with us. You're not birdie enough. Oh, he's very sad. Why don't you find somewhere else? You're not one of us. You're neither. And look, they're all yelling, neither, neither, neither. And neither flies away. High above the landscape, looking down. This is my favorite character. It's the wise old tree. Where did you come from? Honk! He scared him. I'm from the land of this and that, but I'm neither. So I'm looking for somewhere else to fit in. This isn't somewhere else, but you'll fit in here. Where is here? So many different kinds. It's the land of all. Look at all of the different creatures. There's a fox with a clown nose. There's a kangaroo with a unicorn horn. And that is a snake with chicken feathers. So imaginative. Come play with us. But I'm different from everyone here. I'm neither red, nor orange, nor yellow, nor blue. And all of his new friends say, exactly! Oh, maybe he's found some place. Excuse us? We're from the land of this and that. But we don't fit in at home. We're looking for somewhere else. The rabbit and the bird are there now. But you said I was neither. You said I should go somewhere else. Well, this isn't somewhere else. This is the land of all. And everyone fits in here. This is a dog head with a goldfish body. Once upon a time, there were many kinds. This and that. Somewhat, and what not. Either, very, sort of, just, rather, a little, neither, and both. And all were welcome. Oh, isn't that a wonderful story? Everyone is having a good time together. It looks like they're having their own pride celebration as well. Everyone is so happy. Well, go find this book, Neither, by Arlie Anderson, and you can read this in your own home. Bye.
Today is like a chapter in a book you're writing. You decide the way it goes. We hope it's gonna be exciting, but only you can know. Oh, whoa, 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 life.
Hi, everybody. I'm Genevieve from Kids Fringe, and today I'm going to show you how to make a wrapped rainbow stick, or a rainbow wrap stick, And this one we've actually turned into a magic wand. So let's get started. The first thing you need is you need a stick. So I have different sticks here. And I suggest you go on a nature walk. You could go in your yard, or you could walk around your neighborhood with your parents or with your friends, and you want to find a stick. And you want to find sticks that speak to you, whatever it is. It's okay if it's thicker. It's okay if it's skinny. It's okay if it's a little bit longer, all right? Any stick is fine. One thing you want to remember, though, is don't break the stick off the tree. You want to find only sticks that have fallen to the ground. So once you find your stick, you want to start wrapping it with yarn. So I have some that I started, and I'm going to show you, all right? Here's one with lots of rainbow colors. You can use any kind of yarn. I'm using rainbow colors today because I'm celebrating Pride, but you can use anything you have. And so what you're going to do is you're going to take your yarn, and you're going to go around the end of your stick. And I'm taking a little bit of yarn, and I'm tying it. And if the tying part is a little tricky for you, you can ask a grown-up to help you. So I'm tying a little bit, and that just gets the yarn started on my stick. And then from there, I start wrapping. And you can wrap it like this. You can twist the stick and kind of hold the yarn there, and it'll go around as you twist the stick. That's up to you, whatever you find is easy. And I'm glad this stick has a little nub. I like the nubs, they give it personality. You can just go right around it. I'm gonna go over it, and then I'm gonna go on the other side of it. So that's kind of cool. It gives my yarn and my wrapping a little bit of personality. All right, so I've wrapped, and then once you get, right now I'm at the end kind of, you're gonna wrap it a little bit more around, and you're gonna just make another little tie or a little knot, okay? There. Let me try that one more time. My little knot came out. You're gonna pull your yarn through. And there you go. And make that little knot, okay? And then with the extra yarn, because I wanna go to another color, you're just gonna cut it off with your scissors. So I have some orange, and I am going to add that to my stick. So you want to find the end, and same thing. I'm going to show you just from the middle of the stick, but you can go, when you're doing it, you can go from top to bottom, or you could start in the middle and then fill in spots. So I'm going to go right here. I'm going to tie it around. Again, if you need help getting or doing the tie, just ask a grown-up. And I'm going to wrap. And now you might see, I'm going to unwind my yarn a little bit, that I'm getting close to this blue thing. If that's the case and you didn't cut it off, you can just wrap right over it and cover them up. So I'm going to do that with my orange. Oop, cover it up. There you go. And you can also do the method where you twist the stick. And I think that's all the orange I want. So then I'm going to cut and just tie it around kind of the same thing. I made a little loop and I pull it through. And if that is tricky, ask a grown-up, and I'm going to cut off the extra. So I would suggest using more color and going all the way down your stick. But I have one right here that I've been working on, my rainbow stick, and I'm going to turn it into a magic wand. So here's my magic wand, and there's the star at the end. So to make yours a magic wand, you're going to want to grab a marker, or a crayon, or a pencil, whatever you have, piece of paper, I'm using a scrap, and draw a star. You could freehand the star, which means you're just gonna draw it, you're not gonna trace anything, and I think that's what I'm gonna do. And I'm going to give my star 5 points. There's your star. And then cut it out. Take your scissors and cut. Cutting out my star. Once you're finished cutting out your star, mine's a little wacky, but I like it that way. You're gonna grab your tape, ta-da, and decide which end of your stick that you're gonna put the star on. I'm gonna go with the purple end. So I'm gonna take my star, I'm gonna lay it down. I'm gonna take my stick and lay it on top of the star a little bit. And then I'm gonna take some tape and I'm gonna stick it right on. You can use almost any kind of tape. You could use scotch tape. You could use masking tape. You could use duct tape. But I wouldn't use washi tape because washi tape is really pretty, but it doesn't always stick very well. So any of those other kinds of tape is fine. And voila, I now have a magic wand that you can cast spells on your parents, or your friends, or your cat, or your dog. It's pretty cool, I like it. So the next thing we're gonna do is, same idea, we have this cool wrap stick, so we could make it into a magic wand, or we could make it into a cool decoration, maybe something for your room. So this one, here's a rainbow, here's a stick that I wrapped all in the rainbow for my Pride celebration, and I took an extra piece of yarn and I tied it the same way we did the whole time we were wrapping. I tied it right here at the end and then I left a little space and I tied it to the other end so that it's something that could hang. And I think that I would like to hang some pom-poms from that. I think that would look really cool if I hung some pom-poms. So I'm gonna show you how to make a pom-pom. Let's do that. So put that aside. Let's make an orange one because I have lots and lots of orange. So pull out a good amount of yarn, get a big pile, I'm gonna unroll it now, and go to the end. And this part's kind of fun. Take your fingers, 3, 2, whatever works for you, and hook it around. And we're not tying it yet, but we're wrapping it. And I'm just wrapping it around my fingers. So just like we did the stick, but now we're wrapping our own hands or our fingers, that's kind of fun. And you just keep wrapping. And you can wrap, it's okay if you go over top of it a little bit. It's okay if you go next to it. And the more you wrap, the thicker this pom-pom is gonna be. So let me wrap, whoa, a little bit more. And then I'm gonna cut it off and leave a little string like I did, and then take a piece, it can be the same color, but I have another piece of yarn. Take another piece of yarn and lay it down on your table and slide this guy off your fingers and try to keep it smushed together. Lay it down on the yarn and tie it. You're going to tie it like you would tie a sneaker or a little package. I pretend this is a little package. I like that idea. And now this time I suggest you tie it 2 times. So that was 1 and that's 2. And then that excess, you can chop it off, chop that off. And so now you have this neat little package and you see how they're loops, they're little loop-de-loops. You're gonna take your scissors and cut through the loops. Oh, I got them all. And then you turn it over to the other side and cut through the loops. And let's see if you miss any. I always just look and go back, cut those guys. Oh, awesome. Now I have this nifty little orange pom-pom. So we're gonna attach these guys to our stick and that one I showed you before, whoops, with the hanger. All right, I better fix that hanger really quick so you can see how we can tie it around. Get that on there. We'll get there. Doesn't wanna listen to me. There we go. Okay, so to get those pom-poms on, you wanna tie them on, and I think what we're gonna do, we have three, I have three. You can attach as many as you want. I'm going to do a purple one, an orange one in the middle, and a purple one at the end. And all we do is we tie them on. So take this one, and I'm gonna tie it over here, in the red area. This. And I'm going to take my orange one and kind of tie it in the middle. Let's see what I got. And I think I want the orange one to be a little shorter. So I'm going to tie it closer. And you want to tie, I think you should tie these twice also. And then the purple one, we're going to tie. Tying it once, tying it twice. And if you have little stragglers, little extras, just take your scissors and cut off those little pieces hanging off. That's how we tidy it up a little bit. I have a little piece of something there. And then I've tied my little pom-poms, I've fluffed them up, and you have a cool decoration or wall hanging. You could hang it on your porch. You could hang it in your bedroom, maybe in an office. If you're feeling Halloween-y, I'm looking at these guys right now. All they would need is some googly eyes. And now it would be your pride and your Halloween wall hanging. And if you want to get really fancy, now that you know how to wrap these sticks, you can do anything. Check this out. This is a bigger wall hanging that I made, and it's two wrap sticks. This is the piece that we tied on the hang it, and then really long pom-poms. Or, remember, you can also make your magic wand.
All right, boys and girls, before I leave today, I want to share one last story that I want you to take with you and keep in your heart and spread throughout the world, all right? It's called Try a Little Kindness. And I think that we all, even if you're a kind person, try to be even kinder. I think it'll make the world a happier, more loving place, all right? Now, this book is written by Henry Cole, another good friend of mine. It's called Try a Little Kindness. Try a little kindness. A smile to greet the morning, a hug to greet each day, a thank you and a yes please are things that you should say. Our animal friends will show you exactly how it's done. Make it a daily habit. Kindness can be fun. Wake up with a smile. That bear's got a big smile. Rise and shine, it's breakfast time. Look at the spiders, they're waking up. The sloths are smiling. Be the last in line. Look, they're all letting everyone go ahead of them. Invite someone over to play with you. This owl has put the blocks in arrangement. This says, you are nice to this other little bird. And these dogs are playing with a chicken. Red Rover, Red Rover, send the chicken right over. A moose playing go fish with a mouse. A fox and a pig having a tea party. And look, this little mouse has bought this house. And this mouse is coming over to play ball. So invite someone over to play with you. As long as it's safe. Share your toy. A buzzard giving a dog a bone. A cat giving his mouse to another mouse to play with. You'll feel so special inside. Try some kindness every day. A smile, a joke, or something else. Come on, don't you want to play? Squirrels playing ping pong with an acorn. It's crazy. Tell someone they are special. You're special. Look, this little kitty cat is telling his grandma kitty, you're special. This cat is showing this goldfish, he's special. And this little tiny bird is being told by this giant peacock, it's what's inside that counts, is what he tells him. Be a great ally. Do you know what an ally is? An ally is a friend that always has your back and that will always help you out. It's good to be a good ally. Write a poem for someone. Oh, that would be nice. I would love to get a poem from someone. Praise someone's work. If you see something that is good, or tell them how nice it is or how much you enjoy it. Or you could tell your parent or guardian how much you enjoyed their dinner that they made for you. Hold the door for a friend. Now, I hold the door open for lots of different people. I think it's just the easiest, nicest thing that you can do that costs no money, and smile while you do it. Give someone your seat. Oh, look, this little kitty cat has given this mama dog with your baby dog the open seat to sit down. So nice. Pick up the trash. Oh, so easy. I do this anytime I have the opportunity. Just if you see something, pick it up and throw it in the garbage can so it's not blowing around making the earth all dirty. Visit someone who is lonely. Now, this polar bear is sitting on a little iceberg floating, and this penguin has come to say, hello. And this little duck is bringing his duckling grandma some flowers. She looks like she's in the hospital. Oh, I hope she's okay. She must have a runny nose. There's some Kleenex here on the table. And this little buddy is coming to give his other buddy friend a carrot. I know you think we did it, but our job is not quite done. We need to keep on going. Being kind is so much fun. The hare is telling the tortoise after you to go through the finish line. Help someone without being asked. You can always help someone carry the groceries or pick up their paper and take it to them. Read to your friends. Well, that's what we're doing today. I'm reading to all of you. Some of you are my friends and have been for a long time, and some of you I've just met today. So hello, new friends. Hello, old friends. Write thank you notes. Oh, this is one of the most important things. If someone does something kind for you or gives you a present, it's always best to write a handwritten thank you note out. It really makes their heart grow. Do something unexpected. You can help a neighbor sweep up the leaves. Or look at this tortoise is helping a hare into his own shell. Oh my goodness, that's very nice. Take a selfie with friends. Oh, if you see me out, and I would love to take a picture with you if we see each other, so you just flag me down. When evening has come and it's time to go to bed, you brush your teeth and wash your feet and make sure your fish is fed. Think of new good deeds to do and some nice things to say. Then you'll know why kindness counts and look forward to each day. Isn't that nice? So try a little kindness. Do something nice for a stranger. Do something nice for your family or your brother or your sister, and it will come back to you in many, many more ways. I love you all, and I'll see you very, very soon. Bye now. Thank you. person, but this is the next best thing. Thank you to the Kids Fringe and Pride for having me come on here with you. I want to introduce you to what I'm going to do and who I am. First of all, I'm Mr. Mark. A lot of you know me. I play drums around town. And, of course, I have one with me today, my trusty djembe. Now, you might not have one of these at home, but I really want you to play along with me today. So, I'm going to explore some ideas of what you could play with. Let me look around on the floor here. Oh, maybe you have a little toy tambourine. They make really good instruments. You don't have one of those. I don't know. Maybe you got something that makes a cool noise when you shake it. You might have one of those. Maybe you got one of these laying around. Sounds just like the ocean. And I can hit it too. Or, oh, maybe you have. Music box, that'd be cool. And if you don't have any of those things, well, something as simple as two sticks can be hit together. And if you don't have sticks, well, maybe you have spoons. Now, this always reminds me of like a double nostril cleaner, but I'm not gonna do that here. I'm gonna say you can hit these together. And even if you don't have them stuck together, you can just get two spoons and you hold them together in your hand and you can make that noise. If you don't have two spoons, maybe you got a pan or a bucket. Wait. Now, it does sound pretty cool when I put that on and talk like that. Hello! Oh, that really is loud. So maybe you want to keep it off your head, but you can bang it with your fingers. Side, all sorts of different noises. So we're gonna ask you to pause at home so you can find something that you like to make noise with and then come back and join me in just 1 minute after you find that thing. All right, I hope you found something to play with because we are gonna make some noise and we're gonna sing a song here. Now, I know I'm not with you today and I love drumming with everyone in the room with me, but let me tap into my powers of mind. Oh, I'm getting something here. I believe Keon is watching. So let's sing a song welcoming you, sir. And it goes like this. Hello, Keon. How are you? I'm doing fine. How about you? Hello, Keon.
Hello, Ava. How are you? Hello, Ava.
and Antonio. Hello, Antonio. How are you? I'm doing fine. And how about you? Hello, Antonio. How are you? I'm doing fine. And how about you? Hola, Antonio. Watching, so please fill in your name and play one more time with me. Place of rhythm, and the story I'm going to tell is an adaptation of a Nigerian folktale, but it's an adaptation that is special for our event here today. Now, rhythm and stories have been going together for thousands of years, and to me, my opinion, this is the highest form of communication and storytelling, way better than movies. Wink, wink. So, I hope you'll keep drumming with me and help me tell this story. And so we're gonna start with a simple rhythm. And the story begins, and it was a day much like today. And all the animals were hanging out by the lake, enjoying this warm, hot Florida summer. And they were swimming and having a good time. Now let me think. What animals were hanging out by that lake? There was a... what was there?
Alligator!
There was an alligator. There was an alligator. But as I always say, let's make alligators come last. What else might there have been?
Duck!
A duck! Yes, thank you! I'm sure you call that at home too, so here we go! Let's remember those ducks and say, what's the sound a duck makes? Right, what's the sound a duck makes? I know, quack, 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 quack. Can I hear your quacks? Oh, that was a lovely quack. Do it again. Oh, that's really fun. Nice quacks. All right. So the ducks were swimming, and they were waddling around in the water. And what other animal was hanging out by that water?
Duck!
Oh yeah, there was a dog hanging out there. And all the dogs were playing by the water, playing by the water, playing by the water. All the dogs were playing by the water. Now, can you help me remember? What's the sound the dogs make? Ready? Go! Hear your best roof. Oh yeah, that's a great one too. Alright. And let's see. Was there any other animals hanging out by the lake that day? I think there was a
sloth.
Yes, there was a sloth. Who would have thought it? But yes, and for those of you who are very historically minded, there was at one time giant sloths that roamed around in Florida. True story. So all the sloths were climbing by the water, climbing by the water, climbing by the water. All the sloths were climbing by the water. And what's the sound a sloth makes? What's a sound A sloth makes. Kind of like a yawn. Can you make a yawn like that at home? All right, now don't fall asleep on me. There's more story to tell because guess what came back into our story? The alligator. Everyone get your chomps ready. We're going to chomp like the alligator. Chomp, 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 chomp. The alligator was chomping in the water. Chomp, 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 chomp. And that alligator was chomping so loud. It scared off all the other animals. The ducks went quack. The dogs went roo-hoo. And the sloth just went yawn. But anyway, they all ran away as fast as they could, albeit the sloth can't run very fast, but it did get out of there. And they searched for some help because they also wanted to share the water. And they stumbled upon the hero of our story and the hero of Kids Fringe, Fringezilla. And they said, Fringezilla, please help us. Alligator is chomping in the water and not sharing, and we want to use the water too. And Fringezilla said, I know what to do. And Fringezilla walked down to the water. Yeah, Fringezilla was walking down to the water. Walking down to the water. Walking down to the water. Fringezilla was walking down to the water. And when he got there, the alligator was chomping. Chomping. Fringezilla was like, excuse me, Mr. Alligator, excuse me, can you please share the water? But all the animals could hear was chomp, 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 chomp. And again, Fringezilla said, excuse me, Mr. Gator, but please share the water. But all the animals heard was chomp, 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 chomp. And Fringezilla got very, very disappointed and walked off. Kind of sad and not so sure it knew how to help. And at that moment, thankful for our story here, a little tiny creature popped up on Fringezilla. It sounded kind of like that. And it hopped up to his ear. It's a little flea. And the little flea said, Fringezilla! I don't know why a flea sounds like that, but I believe it does. Fringezilla! You must find your true Fringezilla voice. You must go to the Great Cave. And Fringezilla knew, like many animals knew, that this was true. He was a little bit afraid. But nevertheless, with the encouragement of that flea, he started to walk off and find the greatest cave he could find in this area. Here he started walking. All right, so if you want to walk around while I drum, walk around like Fringezilla. Or keep drumming with me. Into a great, powerful space, you must introduce yourself and give yourself a name. And he said, hello, I'm Fringezilla. And as sometimes will happen in caves, there was an echo. Fringezilla here didn't know anything about echoes yet. So he just heard his own voice come back to him. Hello, I am Fringezilla. So he started to think there must be something else in here who thinks it's Fringezilla. And he did not like the idea of that. So he built up his courage and said a little bit louder. This time with a small little Fringezilla roar. Roar. I am Fringezilla. And a moment later, he heard again. Roar. I am Fringezilla. Now he was a little bit scared yet again, but also a little bit more bold. He decided I must roar even louder and introduce myself. I am Fringezilla! Roar! I am Fringezilla! Who said that? He kept wondering. And at that very moment, a little bat came flapping out of the cave roof and came right before Fringezilla and said, Fringezilla, please stop! Every time you introduce yourself, there's an echo and I hear it twice and it scares me two times! You are great and powerful. I can hear it in your roar. Please don't do it anymore. And Fringezilla realized he had found his true Fringezilla roar. And he knew that he must run back to the lake. And that's what he started to do. So you can run with me back to the lake. And when he got to the lake, you know what the alligator's doing. Start your chops. Jump, jump. Fringezilla roars ready. I need you to help. Help at home. Ready? We're gonna roar. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Bat. Roar. I'm Fringezilla. And the gator stopped in its tracks. Oh, excuse me. What can I do for you, Fringezilla? Well, the sloth here, and the duck, and the dog, they all want to share the lake. Can you please share the lake and stop chomping so loudly around and chasing them all off? And the alligator said, okay, sure, Fringezilla. I didn't know I was disturbing everybody. And the animals were so excited, they all jumped back into the water. And they were so excited now that Fringezilla had his true Fringezilla roar. They decided that they were going to have an animal dance party. So I want you to get ready at home. Put on your dancing shoes, or just find a nice open space to dance. And we're going to come back in just a minute and start dancing with you. Hey, welcome back. Look who I found. It's Fringezilla. Let me hear one more Fringezilla roar. Ready? Roar. Welcome, Fringezilla. And it's time for a dance party. Are you ready, Fringezilla? Let's dance at home. We're going to dance here too. All right. Thank you for helping us with the alligator and helping all the animals get back in the lake. Let's celebrate. Thank you. he did these fun crafts, read fantastic stories, and got to play the drums with Mr. Mark. Oh, I am tuckered out. I'm going to go take a nap. Now, boys and girls, make sure you join us throughout the year for all sorts of Kids Fringe activities. And we hope to see you real soon. Let's blow him a kiss, Fringezilla. Bye.
While we can't be face to face, we can still be heart to heart.
Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining us. This is the Pride in the House pre-party with me. My name is Axel Andrews. If you don't know who I am, that's okay. I am a local entertainer that has been involved in the scene for a little over 12 years. I want to thank Come Out With Pride for choosing me to host this event. I'm honored and I am so thankful for it. So thank you, Come Out With Pride. If you don't know what this is, it's a pre-party to the main event. The main event is at 8 o'clock and you'll be able to see headliners like Roxy Andrews and Detox from RuPaul's Drag Race, as well as singer extraordinaire Robin S. But this right now that you're watching, whether you're on the couch or on the toilet or at work, hiding your phone so you can watch a little bit, whatever you're doing, this is the pre-party. This is a virtual show where you're going to see some of the local entertainers that entertain you throughout the week normally. Some of them are new, some of them are a little bit more established, but either way, you're going to see a lot of entertainment and some super amazing people. So if you would like to make a donation to any of these entertainers, their Cash Apps and Venmo will be provided in their videos. But don't feel obligated. You know, it helps a little bit, but we are just thankful to be entertaining right now for you and to show you our talents. If you'd like to make a donation to Come Out With Pride, that's very important. You should definitely do that. Go to www.comeoutwithpride.com and make a donation today, right now. Hopefully we'll be back in the streets loving on each other next year for Pride. That would be amazing. So, all right, everyone. This first entertainer is really amazing. She is a TikTok sensation. She is one of the sweetest people and super talented. This is the one and only Venus Envy. Thank you.
together against the vision and the forces of hate in this country. An attack on one of us is an attack on all of us. We show up. We speak up. And when you vote, we win. Now, we need you to show up for all of us. We vote for equality. Vote early. Vote today.
Hello, Orlando Pride. I just want to tell you, you are not alone. We're in this together. You are loved. So let's celebrate.
That was amazing. Thank you so much. All right, everybody, we're going to move right along to your next entertainer. This next entertainer is a local legend here. She has raised thousands of dollars for the Trevor Project through Broadway Christmas, which is her annual event where we get together and we all do Broadway numbers and we raise money for that great cause. She is the mother of the House of Adonis, and she has taught a lot of people, you know, what to do here in Orlando. So show some virtual love for Kaya Adonis.
This is not a second chance, no baby. This is not a new bone that's meant to me. Oh, this is for the nights that bother you, baby. When you could be the one that could love me right. I'll be here to love myself, you're vulnerable to without you. In the middle of the power of the girls with the brain inside. Oh, oh. So tonight I'm staying alone. Another break up song. Turn it up, let it play. On and on and on and on. All the time they scrub your soul. Let it play on and on and on. Just another break up song. We're going to cry. I ain't even gonna call you, no babe. The best thing I ever did was to let you go. Did you think you were the only one that could save me? I ain't gonna take you back like I did before. Myself, yeah, I'll find a way to dance without you. In the middle of the problems, get a love to play inside. Oh, oh. So
plus family this weekend.
Our rights are on the line this November, especially for our Black and Brown family members.
We need you to make a plan to vote now.
Early voting starts on October 19th.
From the top to the bottom of the ballot, we need you to vote for those candidates who will fight for us in all levels of government. Your voice matters. Go vote!
Happy Pride! My name is Joseph Knoll. You may know me as Joey. I'm the founder of Spectrum Health. I started this organization because our community needed a better health experience.
Compassionate.
Acceptance.
Friendly. Knowledgeable. Safe.
Liberating.
Passionate.
You won't be sorry.
Convenient, affordable, LGBT-focused healthcare for everyone, everywhere, every time.
To me, Pride is somewhere where all members of the LGBTQ+ community are welcome to be their authentic selves.
That was awesome. All right, everybody, please make some noise for your next entertainer. Show them some love.
So this is an original that I wrote, one of very, very few originals I've ever written. And it's just sort of a tribute to my time here in Japan and just reminiscing back on everything that has happened to me. And this is also the first time I've performed an original in front of a live audience, so, or in front of an audience in general. But hope you guys enjoy.
Said I was brave. They said, what do you think I love? Black and love, taking off and moving on. To lead all I knew, to begin on. A different place with different fears, but new friends are always near. A sense of hope with every dawn and the beautiful language of men. I don't have the words to describe how I feel.
Thank you.
your own true self. It means not feeling shame for being you, not even for a second. It means not having to hide from yourself or from anyone else. It means surrounding yourself with those who really love you for who you are, no matter what. Happy Pride.
We're going to move right along, everyone, to your next entertainment. But before we do, don't forget if you'd like to make a donation to Come Out With Pride, it is www.comeoutwithpride.com. If you're just now joining us, this is the pre-party for Pride in the House, which the main show is at 8 o'clock. But we're going to move right along, everyone. This next entertainer is one of the most impressive makeup artists I know, has a very unique style, I love this person inside and out. Please show a lot of virtual applause and love to Waka Shame.
So sour candy. So sour candy. I'm sour candy, so sweet that I get a little angry, yeah. Sour candy, yeah, 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 yeah. I'm super psycho, make you crazy when I turn the lights low. Sour candy, yeah, 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 yeah. I'm sweet to be nice and then I'll do it extra mean. The bucket goes on high, and that one I can see. It's not just it, I'm a little bit pulled down, I'm going loyal. If you wanna fix me, then let's break up here and now. Gotta give up my love, and I'm got it on the go. The problem I don't give up, she's so digital. Wow, oh, 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 oh. I'm hard on the outside, but if you give me time, that I could make time for your love. I'm hard on the outside, but if you see inside, inside, inside.
I might be messed up, but I know what's up. You want a real taste, at least I'm not a fake.
Come, come, come at me. Come, come, come at me.
Show you what's me. Close your eyes, don't peek. Now I'm undressing. Unwrap sour candy.
Come, come, come at me. Come, come, come at me.
Sour candy.
I'm hot on the outside, but if you give me time, then I could make time for your love. I'm hot on the outside, but if you see inside, inside, inside.
I'm sour candy, so sweet that I get a little angry, yeah. Sour candy, yeah, 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 yeah. I'm super psycho, looking crazy when I turn the lights low. Sour candy, yeah, 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 yeah.
Take a bite, take a bite. So sour candy, take a bite, take a bite. So sour candy, take a bite, take a bite. So sour candy, take a bite, take a bite. Sour candy.
Take away from Pride today, most importantly, that you're loved and supported. That you know that you were born exactly the way you were supposed to be born. And you make up the great tapestry of our community. Without your thread, we would not be whole. That you have a vital, viable life and voice, and that you indeed have a seat at our table and at every table. Much love and happy Pride.
Yes, that was awesome. Thank you so much. We are going to move right along, everyone, to your next entertainer. She is also a local legend here in Orlando. She is a staple. She has guided so many youth and young entertainers, the youthfulnesses. She has guided a lot of people on their journey for drag and helped a lot of us out. She actually gave me my very first booking ever, and I'm super grateful. She is the mother of the House of Gemini. This is Katana Gemini.
Yeah, little mama, you looking good. I see you wanna play with a player from the hood. Come holler at me, you got it like that. Big Snoop Dogg with the lead pussy cat. I show you how I throw that. Yeah, I wanna throw that. Me and you one on one, treat it like a show that. You look at me and I look at you. I'm reaching for your shirt, what you want me to do?
I'm telling you, I'm sending my buttons, babe. I have a dream from now. Say what you gonna do to me. I have a icy night. I'm telling you, I'm sending my buttons, babe.
Grateful for is that we have this beautiful community in Orlando who comes together when times are tough. We know after Pulse, you know, think about how much love and compassion and kindness and outpouring of support there was. This is the time where we need to band together. We need to support one another. We need to prove that love is the only answer, and that When we stay united, when we support one another, when we stand in solidarity with one another, when we stand up for one another, that there's nothing that we can't accomplish. I think that, once again, Orlando can be the beacon of hope, of love, of compassion, of kindness in this world that desperately needs it. So, I love you, Orlando.
Yeah, woo-hoo-hoo. That was awesome. Okay, everyone, we're going to move right along to your next entertainer. She is the host of Creature Feature. You can catch that on Tuesday nights over at Southern Nights at 10 o'clock with her partner, Victoria Elizabeth Black. She is super talented, amazing, another great entertainer here in Orlando with a very unique, awesome style. Show her some virtual love. This is Opulence Black.
Tuesday, if you'd like the interview with Coco Peru today. Well, there's plenty more coming, right, Michael?
Right. To find those episodes, you can go to www.perfectlyqueerpodcast.com.
Ooh, keep out all of our updates, special guests, videos, and more. That's PerfectlyQueerPodcast.com.
Let me be perfectly queer.
Pride is so much more than a celebration. It started as a protest led by trans women of color against forces who tried to silence and diminish our community. It's our annual reminder that we won't let anyone take our power away. It's a way of proclaiming to yourself and to the world that I'm worthy of respect and love and equality. And this year, it's more important than ever to make sure your voice is heard.
I will keep stay with me. I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors. Your true colors are beautiful like a rainbow.
I think Pride is so important because it's that one time of year that everybody in the community can come out and just see how large our community is in Central Florida. It's just insane how big of a crowd we have. I think it was 170,000 last year, almost 200,000. But it's great to see everybody who's a part of our community come out.
Yes, that was awesome. Thank you so much. All right, everybody, we're going to move right along. This next entertainer you can catch at Parliament House. She's a footlight player. She's currently doing some really cool makeup tutorials and things like that online, so make sure you check her out. She is the body beautiful. She is the ginger goddess. She is beautiful inside and out. If you ever get a chance to meet her, you're going to know why. She is fantastic. So show some virtual love for Melanie Von Cruz.
He's fine. He always keeps me guessing, but never keeps me guessing about his world. He's had more girls than Howard Hughes had money, and that's all. And you may think it funny when I say he loves me only, but who are you to say what he does when I'm not around? Just because I fell in love with Casanova Brown. Act two, scene five. It's my performance. My name is Clara Voyant, and it's all to me. I was the one who said to him tomorrow, I love to the full motto, even when I never sleep.
It hurt me, but I had to let
Victims of all crime, sexual assault, and we also work as the Rape Crisis Center for Central Florida.
We have free services that we serve clients for counseling, for group counseling and trainings, and we have specific services for the LGBTQ community.
If you want to find out more, go to our website at victimservicecenter.org or call our helpline, which is 24/7 at 407-500-HEAL.
Happy Pride!
While 2020 has been a challenging year, it offered me some inspiration to collaborate with my fellow team and think more creatively of ways that we could still celebrate Pride without sacrificing health and safety.
All right, everyone, the time has come for the best entertainer in the history of the world, or maybe the worst. Depends on who you are, because drag is subjective. But show some love for me. This is my video. Thank you so much, eBay, for doing all the videography work for this. I love you. I hope you enjoy.
Cold. His hands are meant to hold. You've lost. gotta keep you strong. Move along, move along, like I know you do. And even when your hope is gone, move along, move along, just to make it through. And all you gotta keep is
is doing what she's always done.
She is laser focused.
Big plans for Congressman Val Demings.
She's doing the work, expanding Medicaid, protecting small businesses, and extending COVID unemployment benefits.
Sometimes you don't choose the situation. Sometimes the situation chooses you.
She has the skills to get things done.
Val Demings, doing the work.
Pride to me means we're not just celebrating our victories and accomplishments, but we're also looking forward and continuing to fight for progress and equality. Pride is about visibility and about using our collective voices. So let's start by voting for candidates this election who are going to support our community, and then let's work together to build a brighter and better future.
Music's pumping, it will give you new life.
Pride to me. Pride is more than a festival. It's more than a parade. It's more than a flag. Pride is walking down the street with my girlfriend's hand in mine. Pride is being an example to her and to others that have been taught to feel shame for being true to themselves. Pride is preparing the way for my niece as she joins our loving community. Pride is showing others how to accept who they are, even when the world doesn't want to accept them. Pride is promoting tolerance, diversity, unity, living every day with integrity and honesty, knowing that I'm making a difference. We belong here. We are enough and we matter. Happy Pride.
Well, that does conclude the show, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for supporting. If you tip the entertainers, I'm sure they're super grateful. If you made a donation to come out with Pride, thank you, thank you, thank you. That was amazing. If you haven't and you would like to, you can go to www.comeoutwithpride.com. I want to thank the Pride Committee. I want to thank Rob Ward, Jeff, everyone for putting this together. Thank you for allowing me to host it. Thank you for allowing us to showcase our talents that you can see weekly at some of the clubs and bars. So thank you again. One more time, if you want to donate, www.comeoutwithpride.com. The main event is coming up at 8 o'clock, everyone. So coming up, the headliners are Roxy Andrews from RuPaul's Drag Race, Detox from RuPaul's Drag Race, and Robin S., the singer. You're also going to see a lot of other little treats in there. So tune in, everyone. And until then, I'm going to say good night, Axel.